Today, a desperate father of a demon-possessed young man approaches Jesus and begs, "If you can do anything, help us." And Christ replies, "If you can believe, then all things are possible to him who believes." Christ brings that father and all of us in front of our responsibilities. And even the casting out of demons depends on us, on our own faith alone. Unbelievable and yet true. Today, Christ highlights a really important issue of all mankind: our faithlessness. O faithless generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Faith is the way out for all our dead ends. It is the help and the solution to all our problems. It is the seed that will spiritually cultivate both us and our children. It is that little mustard seed that the Lord mentions somewhere else that is able to move mountains. Faith can cast out demons, can free us from our passions, can make us walk on the waves. I think it is better not to question whether we have as much faith as a mustard seed, not because we don't, but because it is better to attempt to understand our deepest issue. So, let us wonder instead why the apostles, who certainly had more faith than we do, after proving it by giving up everything to follow Christ, why couldn't they also cast out the demon? Why could even the faithful followers of Christ be able to remove this mountain? The spiritual condition of the apostles at that time is more or less similar to the condition of many of us, who, while we think we're following Christ, cannot help our fellow people and cannot even help ourselves, only because we simply remain full of ourselves. The continuation of today's passage proves the truth of that statement when it reveals that immediately after the healing of the demon-possessed young man, the apostles were wondering among themselves who was the best, who was the greatest, and who was the worthiest among them. Unfortunately, they had not yet understood, as most of us, that a true Christian loves others more than himself. And definitely, this self-centered competition among them proved just the opposite. When I compete with the other people, it means that I'm full of myself. I fail to be empty of my ego and filled with God, and therefore, I cannot cast out any demon from anyone, not even the slightest passion from my own self. I fail to focus on God, and I focus on myself. I fail to deny my ego, and I deny God instead. Our Lord Jesus Christ told us last week that if we want to follow him, we need to deny ourselves first. So, it is very important every time to refuse to act selfishly, to choose to comfort others and not ourselves. This is how we deny ourselves. This is how we focus on God. This is how we follow him. When wherever we do it for God and for others. Then we truly empty ourselves and create space inside us for the Holy Spirit. And then all demonic influences are simply history. So we first heal ourselves from the slavery of our passions, which is also a demonic energy within us, and then we can help other people around us. But when we want to be above others, even if we have mountains of faith, we're not going to move even the smallest mustard seed. That's why the apostles couldn't cast the demon away from the poor young man. This kind cannot be driven out by anything but prayer and fasting. Prayer means keeping all our focus on God, the same way people in love think all day long of the one they love. And fasting means staying away from everything that feeds and sustains our selfishness and our passions. This is the type of prayer and fasting that Christ talks about. This is the type of prayer and fasting that proves our living faith. This is the way we empty ourselves of our ego and we force God to fill us with His Holy Spirit. Otherwise, our selfish spirit will continue to rest within us and will never be able to drive out any unclean and evil spirit. Competitiveness, self-centeredness, and pride are not Christian characteristics. They are not signs of enlightened people. They are signs of darkness. And darkness cannot drive out darkness. It is impossible. Darkness has no substance. Darkness is the absence of light. That's why as soon as we turn on the light, darkness immediately dissolves. It doesn't exist. So, it is impossible for us too to focus on Christ, to focus on the only true light and not be bright ourselves. It is impossible to be united with Christ and have darkness around us or within us. Brothers and sisters in Christ, it is time to stop being spiritually ignorant and start cultivating ourselves and our children with the seed of our faith. Let us not focus only on providing materials, comforts, education, and physical health, and keep ignoring our eternal soul. All our souls are thirsty for heaven. So let us keep our focus on heaven. Let us keep focusing on God, because we do not know how long He will bear with us and how long He will be with us. It is a shame that Christ gives authority to those who believe in Him for all things to be possible for them, but we always choose to see everything as impossible. Please remember that with Christ, nothing is impossible. Christ is telling us today that if you can believe, then all things are possible to him who believes. Amen.